Came home from school not interested in science. These local parents found a way to pique his interest. Now, through their foundation, they're helping students of all ages with an innovative approach. WGN's Lauren Jiggets has the story of two of Chicago's very own.
You recalibrate it?
Yeah.
You're good? Okay.
All extremely interactive. It's all about having a problem that they have to solve.
Steve and Sheila Connors say when their son Stone expressed his extreme dislike for middle school, they knew they had to take action and began asking him about his interests.
Anything to do with cars, robots, anything
Speed.
That was fast, right? And so we created a program around him that we would go and investigate those things.
By visiting car museums and other real-world experiences, the Connors were able to capture their son's attention.
So what do you think we could potentially add to make the scene better?
But also left the pair with the desire to help other students.
If they were more like interactive,
we realized is our kid represented many, many, many other kids.
Right.
And that's when we thought, you know what, this is an issue and we have a solution that we can provide.
And you made it.
I made it.
You made it.
Yeah.
In 2014, the duo founded the Heph Foundation, short for the Greek god Hephaestus. It's a standards-aligned program that teaches science, technology, engineering, and math, or STEM. By using technology and other project-based learning, students learn by doing.
Nice.
12-year-old Maxwell built this remote-control vehicle from scratch.
It's basically like a robot. It's like, you know, it's almost like a car, almost, but it has a claw that, you know, moves and opens up and everything, and then it also can move up and down.
Proud of his work, Maxwell says the project did not feel like learning and it boosted his confidence.
I knew I was learning, but I didn't really feel like it. I didn't even think about, like, am I really learning? And it was something new I was actually learning.
The Connors say technology such as this interactive video game can make learning fun and interesting.
And it's all about, you know, going into a specific environment, no matter what that environment is, assessing it, and giving them a problem.
The program called Dream Teams was first introduced to students at Oak Park River Forest High School. When the COVID-19 pandemic began, the innovative pair made a smooth transition to home learning.
Do you want to talk about...
Carrie Summey is with the Oak Park River Forest Community Foundation.
So they drop off a gift, doorbell rings, kid leaves the Zoom, goes, opens the door, there's their kit. And it's all this great, you know, engineering materials. They're building all this fun stuff, interacting with their classmates.
In 2022, the Oak Park River Forest Foundation awarded the Connors a $1.2 million grant for their work. The foundation's president and CEO, Tony Martinez, says although the donors are anonymous, it's important that the Connors are allowed to build on the contributions they've made to students and the community.
They're the type of folks that really do the grind and the hard work, and they're just, their enthusiasm, their energy is amazing, and they're nonstop, to be honest with you.
The Connors say the best part is the reaction they receive from the children.
At the end, they get a lab coat. And they put it on and they're so proud.
Right.
It's like, oh my God, we're done. That's all you want.
Steve and Sheila Connor, they're Chicago's very own.
And that was Lauren Jiggets reporting. The couple says they'll use the grant money to expand the program and their goal is to reach 10 million students nationwide.